In this video, I'm going to show you how to add Adobe fonts to your Squarespace website. The process of adding Adobe fonts to your Squarespace website is completely different from the process of adding just any other custom font file to your website, which I did cover in my last video. So if that's what you're trying to do, go check out that video instead. This video is if you have an Adobe plan that gives you access to Adobe fonts and you want to use one of those Adobe fonts on your website. So if you have a Creative Cloud subscription, that gives you access to Adobe fonts and you can use them on your website or in your marketing materials to create assets. You can use them anywhere for personal and commercial use. The only downside to this is that if you ever decide to cancel your Creative Cloud subscription, you're going to have to change the fonts on your website because you will lose access to them. So let's get started by signing in to our Adobe account. And then I'm going to go over to Browse All up here. These are all the fonts we have available and they have these handy filters over here that you can use to find the perfect font for your website. So let's say I want to find a futuristic font. As you're browsing through, you can see some of these have more fonts included in them, and that would be like different font weights or italic or just like different styles of the fonts. So you can click on the font to see all of those different styles. See, this one just has like bold, condensed. Once you find a font that you like, you're going to press this button right here to add it to a web project. You can also use this button up here at the top of the font page, which would allow you to add multiple styles of the font to your website all at once. So I'll show you what that looks like. See, there's like these different versions of the font. I would recommend only selecting the ones that you're really going to use on your website, because your website is going to have to load all of the fonts that you choose here, and more fonts equals slower loading times. So I'm just going to choose semi-bold, and I'm going to use this as the header font on my website, and I'm going to uncheck all of the rest of them. But if you want to also use like this font, the light version, for like the body text or like the paragraph text, then you can include multiple fonts like this. So I'm just going to include one for now, and then you're going to go up here and click on this little drop down, and you're going to create a new project, and then you're going to type in here and give it a name. So I'm just going to type in test website, but you can call it whatever you want. And then I'm going to hit create. So this is the code we need to add to our Squarespace website. We'll start with this line of code up here. So you can just copy this. We need to paste this line of code into the code injection area of our Squarespace website. So if we go over to our website and then go to pages and then scroll down to custom code, we have two options, custom CSS or code injection. And this one is going to go in code injection, and it's going to go specifically in the header. So I'll paste it right here and then I'm going to save. This code injection feature is not available on the lowest tier of the Squarespace plan. So you have to bump up to at least the second tier. So let me show you. You need at least this core plan. So if you scroll down, you see this code injection right here. This is the feature we need, and it's not available on the lowest tier. So if you want to use Adobe fonts on your website, you will need to have at least this core plan or higher. Okay, so now that we've added that and we've saved it, I'm going to go back and I'm going to go to custom CSS. So now we have to tell Squarespace where we want it to use that new font that we just added, like which elements, which text elements. I kind of went into this in my last video on adding custom fonts to your Squarespace website. So if you want a deeper dive into how this works, definitely go check out that video. But just as a quick refresher, if you go into edit and you go here, we have all of these different types of text that we can use on our website. And each of them has a corresponding identifier that can be used in CSS to reference that type of text block. If I exit out of here, if we want to apply that new font only to heading one, then I would type H1 brackets, enter, and then we're gonna go back over to Adobe Fonts. And this is the code that we're gonna add to the CSS. So I'm just gonna copy this and paste it right in between these brackets here. See? So if I wanted to apply this new font to all of the headings, then we would do H1, H2, H3, H4, and also we would probably want it to apply to headings that have links in them. So we also have to have H1A, H2A, H3A and H4A. So if you want more of an explanation of what I'm doing here, I go over this in my last video, so check that out. So that's pretty much how you add an Adobe font to your Squarespace website. But there may be some issues that come up with trying to do bold and italics for some of your fonts. I'm going to show you an example of an issue you might run into with italics. I'm going to specifically look for a font that has an italic version that looks different from the regular version. It's easy to see with serif fonts the most, I think. So for example, see how this italic looks different from the regular font? It almost looks like a script version of the font. I'm going to demonstrate something for you. So first, I'm just going to add this font right here to the web project, and I'm not going to add the italic version for now, just to show you what happens. I'm going to click on Add to Web Project, and I'm going to click on the dropdown and add it to the project that we already created. So we don't have to add a new project here. And then I'll save it. So we don't need to add this line again to our website because it's the same project identifier. It should be the same exact line of code that we already added. But this down here is different. This is defining the actual font that we just added. So Ellery is the name of the font. So I'm gonna copy this and then go back to our website, and I'm gonna apply this font to all of the paragraphs on our website. So we already applied the other font to the headings, so this time I'm gonna apply it to the paragraphs. And to do that, you can just type a lowercase p, brackets, and then paste the code right here. You can see that this now picked up the new font, the Ellery font. Let me save this, and I'm gonna make the font size bigger so it's easier for you to see. Can you see that this italic text right here is just slanted? It's not using that same kind of script italic font that we have here, right? And that's because we didn't include this in our web project. The browser is just attempting to do like a fake italic here, and it's just like rendering the letters kind of slanted. And it's also doing the same for the bold text here, but that's not as easy to tell in this case, but it might be easier to tell for certain fonts. So if you're seeing like some weird rendering issues with the bold text, then you might want to do this next step that I'm about to tell you. What we need to do is we need to add the italic version and also the bold version, and maybe even the bold italic version if you want to do both bold and italic at the same time sometimes. I am going to just go to this button up here, add to web project, so I can add multiple at once. I'm going to include regular italic, bold, and bold italic. So there's four of them selected here, and I'll add it to this same project that I created before, and then I'll hit save. We can now go back to our Squarespace website, and we should be able to just refresh the page and see that instead of using the slanted italic, it now uses the actual italic font that looks like a script, this one. And it might be harder to tell, but it's also using the correct bold font as well. So I took a screenshot of what it was before so we can compare. You can really tell the difference between the slanted italic, like the faux italic, and the actual italic, as well as like the bold too is noticeably different. If you can see, like the serifs are like thinner here, and even like the E kind of tapers in to be a little bit more thin. So we didn't have to do any other changes to the code. You just have to make sure that the font files are included in your web project. If you exit out of that web project pop-up and you want to go back and see the fonts that you have in your web project, you can go up here to under Manage Fonts and then go to Web Projects. This is where you would have your web projects. And if you go to Edit Project, this is where you can see all the different styles of the font that you've loaded. So like here under Ellery, we have all four of these fonts. And if you need to copy the CSS again, this is where you would do that as well. In this instance, even though we have four different fonts, you only need to copy the regular font, the CSS for the regular font, and then the others would automatically get applied by Squarespace. Okay, and you may have noticed that the button and the header navigation links and the site title, none of these have taken the new font. So if we also want to apply this font to links, we can do A. A stands for anchor, which is the HTML element for links. If it's not applying to all of them, we should probably also include exclamation point important, and we should include that up here too. Oh, we already did. Okay. So now that font is being applied to all of the links. You may run into this issue that I ran into while I was making this video, which is that it seems like if you already have this loaded onto your website and then you go into Adobe Fonts and you make changes to that web project, sometimes it takes a while for the changes that you made to sync up to your website. And it can be a little bit frustrating because you don't know if it's not working or if it's just not loaded yet. And I mean a while. I was waiting like half an hour before these fonts actually synced up to the website. If you're not sure if the fonts have loaded or not, what you can do is if you right click and go to inspect and then go to network, and then if you click on font, if you don't see it, you might have to make it bigger. See how big my window is? If yours is small like this and you don't see font, you might have to make this bigger by like dragging it. So click on font, stay on this page and refresh the page, and now you can see it's loading fonts. We're looking for the one that matches the ID of our web project. So if I go over to code injection, see how this is EUD0EMI, same as this right here. So I'm gonna click on that file, the CSS file. This file will show you which fonts are being loaded from Adobe Fonts. And you can see that it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fonts here. So it loaded all 4 of those Ellery fonts. And then it also loaded that heading font that we first initially added. So before, when I was viewing this panel, when the font hadn't synced yet from Adobe Fonts, all I was seeing was this header font, the video font that we initially added, and one of these Ellery fonts. I wasn't seeing all 4 of these. So there were only 2 font faces loaded. And that's how I knew that the changes that I made to add all of these other font types had not yet been synced up to my website. So hopefully if you're frustrated and not sure if your font changes have synced up properly or if it's just not working, you can come into this file and see if they're loaded yet. And if not, then you just have to like be patient and wait, I guess. If you don't want to wait, you could just create a new web project in here and just add all of the fonts that you want all in one go. So that's just like if you're getting impatient and you don't want to keep waiting. Hopefully that helped. If it did, I would really appreciate it if you could hit the like button underneath this video and or leave me a comment. If you need more help with your Squarespace website, why don't you head on over to my website where you can learn how you can hire me to help you with some technical issues like installing fonts, or you can hire me to build the whole website for you. I can also do that. And I have a lot of other resources and stuff over there. So check it out, jen-webb.com. I'll also leave the link in the description below. That's all for now. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.